This morning in your Bibles in Proverbs chapter 3, looking at verses 1 through 13, speaking on the term trusting God. Proverbs here is written by Solomon, one of the wisest men that ever lived. And he pens these words for us. He said, "My son, forget not my law, but let thy heart keep my commandments." And this is the Lord speaking through Solomon. "For the length of the days and long life and peace shall thou add to thee. And let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about thy neck and write them upon the tables of thy heart. So shall they find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and man. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not unto thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Be not wise in their own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. It shall be health to their navel and marrow to their bones. Honor the Lord with their substance and with the first fruit of their increase. So shall their bonds be filled with plenty, and their presses shall burst with new wine. My son, despise not the chastening of the Lord, neither be weary of his correction. For whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth, even as a father the son in whom he delighteth. Happy is the man that findeth wisdom, and the man that getteth understanding." How many of us really, really trust God? We trust God at the time that we get saved and we ask the Lord to come into our heart and believe in him and believe that he died for us and ask him to forgive us of that sin. He comes into our heart. We trust him for that. We trust him that he's going to take our souls to heaven just like he declares in his word. But after that, our trust kind of goes downhill. Because see, when it comes to serving and growing in the grace of God, and we kind of put him on the back burner, then we don't trust him with the first fruit of all that he has blessed us with. And I think the first commandment here is saying here in this chapter is that we to obey the Lord Jesus Christ and all that he has commanded us to do. Is that not correct? If we're going to obey him, then friend, we need to listen to what he has commanded us to do and do it. Right? Y'all help me out, it'll go a lot quicker. But we have a problem trusting God. We have a problem trusting God. And friend, this morning I want to talk with you. Do we really trust him? Do we really trust what he says in the book? And friend, if you don't study the book, you don't know what God says to you. You don't know what he's commanding you to do. But there's more to serving God than coming up and uttering a few words and say, "Lord Jesus, come into my heart and save my soul." That's the first step. But there's a lot more to it than that, friend. Because when I surrender my heart to Jesus Christ as a little boy, my life begins to change at that very moment. Jesus spoke to Nicodemus in John chapter 3. He said, you know, that you was born a physical birth. That's flesh. When you was born of the flesh, that was flesh. It's a physical process. You can't go back and be reborn again. You're only born one time into this world. He said there must be a born again the second time, and that's by the Spirit of God. You must be born into the family of God if you're going to live eternally in heaven with him. And the first step to that process of being born again is asking Jesus Christ into your heart. And after that, then friend, we begin a lifelong journey with the Lord Jesus Christ. Paul said, "It's no longer I liveth, but it's Christ that liveth in me." So I must begin to learn how to live for Christ. Because this is a new life, and 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, "Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new." Have they become new for you today? Have you been born again? Have you took that first step? Then, friend, you are on your way to trusting God. But there's a continuing process after that. I must grow in the grace of God and to know how to live this new life that God wants me to live. He wants me to be a vessel of usage. Hello? He wants to use me. He wants to use you. And thank God, amen, he's using many of you. But many of you, amen, have never trusted God to use you in the service capacity yet. And you must yield yourself to God and His will for your life. And the steps to this is following Him as a servant, doing what He's commanded you to do. Matter of fact, He's commanded you to study the Word of God. How many of us take time to study the Word of God each day? How many of us take time to pray one for another? How many of us take time to love one another? Love, amen, love one another, even as Christ loved you. And He says this, friend, how can you love one another unless you love me first? Because you don't know how to love until you love God, right? God is love. If you want to know what genuine love is, love God first. Then you'll experience genuine love among one another. Now, let me ask you this. He says this as well. How can you say you love me whom you have not seen, and you can't love the one you're sitting next to? You haven't seen Him yet, have you? The only visible signs we have is His Word. We hadn't seen Him in a physical form yet. Hello? So how can you love me, He says, whom you have not seen, and you can't love the person that's sitting next to you? Ooh, makes us want to think, do we? Are we really trusting God? Are we following Him? Doing what He's commanded us to do? That's the first step, amen, in trusting God. Doing what He's commanded you to do. And that's what it says right here in Proverbs, verse 1, right? Do what God has commanded you to do. Love one another, even as Christ also loved you and gave Himself for you. Husband, love your wives. I'll move over here. Husband, love your wives. How many of you love your wife like Christ loved the church? Well, wait a minute, preacher. How did Christ love the church? Well, I want to tell you, according to His Word, He gave Himself for the church. Have you given your all for your beloved? Are you selfish? Are you selfish? Because, see, when we trust God, we're no longer selfish. We don't longer have pride building up in us that we want to please ourselves, but we want to please Him. You see, when I'm trusting God, I want to please Him, not me, not you, but Him. I want to please Him. If I please Him, then I'm going to please some of you. I ain't going to please all of you. Because all of you, amen, won't accept the truth. But if we all follow it in truth, we'll be in harmony. Hello? And who is the truth? It's the Lord Jesus Christ. It's the Lord Jesus Christ. If I want to know what truth is, then I look right here. If I want to know what lies and deceit is, I look in the world. It's full of lies and deceit. You'll probably hear a bunch of them, amen, this November at election time. Hello? You'll hear a bunch of them at election time. They'll tell you everything you want to hear except what you need to hear. Hello? It don't matter whether you're on a Democrat or Republican or the dog catcher side. Hello? My friend, listen, we need to learn the truth. What is the truth? Truth is measured from the book called the Bible. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come into the Father except by me. So if you're going to get to heaven, friend, you ain't getting there by your good deeds or your good works down here. You're only going to get there when you have surrendered your life to Him that is useful to Him and obeys His commandments and trust Him totally. Friend, that is planting deep roots. When we trust God and we study the Word of God, we apply His commandments to our life, then that is deep roots. The trees, amen, begins to dig in deeper, amen. The Bible says in Jeremiah, Jeremiah, let me get that verse for you. Slipped my mind, but I got it right here. Thank the Lord. In Jeremiah 17:8, he says we need to be like a tree that is planted by the waters. We need to be like a tree that's planted by the water. Its roots run deep to the water. And he says when the sun comes and the heat comes and the problems comes its way. And guess what, friend? If you're not in a storm right now, because life is full of problems, the storms are going to come. Amen. It's going to come. And it depending on whether you got deep roots or not, whether you're going to stand the storm. A tree that's got deep roots can stand any storm that comes its way because its roots run deep. And friend, the Bible says here that the roots run to the water. What is the way we dig roots, amen, and get rooted and grounded? It's through the Word of God. It is the living water. It is the living water. So our roots must run deep in the study of the Word of God. So it will have the water, amen, that will make the roots strong. It makes the tree strong, and it makes it stand any storm that it encounters. Are you with me? Are you with me? He says, it don't matter if the heat comes, it leaves still green. Don't matter what it faces, it'll still produce fruit because it has deep roots. You got a testimony when your roots run deep in the Word of God. You have a testimony. You bear fruit. That means you're a witness for God. Amen? And when you're a witness for God, you plant seeds to others that comes up. Amen. And makes them rooted and grounded in God. They know about your God. Hello? The problem with the world today is Christian folks have been silent. We need to be the voice. We need to be the tree that's planted by the water. And I shall not be moved. Some of us took that literally and sat on the pew. And I shall not be moved, huh? The Baptist theme song. I shall not be moved. Huh? But we need to be moving for God. Amen? Moving for God. And matter of fact, in the book of Isaiah, I don't know, the Lord just gave me this. He said, if you didn't want to hear me preach this like this, he said, the trees will be able to clap their hands if I preach to them. Have you got deep roots? Because storms are going to come. How many of you trust God when storm comes in your life? How many times we when storms come our way, we try to handle the problem instead of allowing God to handle the problem. We try to fix it. We can't fix nothing. You know that? Because life is too complicated for our little simple infinite mind. You know, we need to ask God for wisdom. Amen. And strength during those difficult times. Matthew 14, real quickly. I ain't going to keep you long. I ain't going to keep you till about 2 o'clock. Amen. Matthew 14. Disciples were told by Jesus to get into the ship and go to the other side. He sent a multitude away that he just had fed. He sent the multitude away. They was obedient to what he commanded them to do. They got in the ship and it was heading to the other side. And Jesus went into the mountain to pray, the Bible says. And while he was praying, a storm had came up where the disciples were, and they were in trouble. They were in trouble. Water was coming into their boat, and they were in the midst of the sea. They were in the middle. So that it was just as far to swim to shore as it was the other way as well. So they were in the middle. They was in deep trouble. Deep trouble. They couldn't swim in this rough water. Their boat was filling up. It was about to sink. They was going down. How many of you feel that way, that the storm is so great in your life at this very hour? It may not be a literal rainstorm, but the storm of life has brought you troubles and heartaches and infirmities, and you feel like your ship is going down. But let me assure you one thing, you got to trust God, because God rises above every storm that we have. God rises above everything that we'll ever confront in this life, because He is an awesome God. We discovered that last week when we said that Jesus is
awesome.
Jesus is
awesome.
I can't hear you. Jesus is
awesome.
And if He's awesome, then He's all sufficient. Amen. And if He's awesome, what is He? He's eternal. He's everlasting to everlasting. He's the Word. He's the Logos. Amen. He's the seeking Savior. He's omnipotent. He's all-powerful. He's all-present. Amen. He's everywhere. And He's everything. Amen. He's memorable. You'll never forget Him. If He comes into your heart, you'll never forget Him. And bless God, let me tell you what. He saw His disciples, and He went to them. Aren't you glad God goes to you in your most difficult time? He didn't get in a boat and go. That means, amen, He don't depend upon the things in this world. Are you with me? Neither should you and I depend upon the things of the world. We should depend upon the Lord who owns the world. He walked on water to them. Now, 11 of them in the boat didn't really trust Him. They knew Him. But they didn't really trust him. They said, that's a ghost. Others said, no, that's Jesus. And I believe the one who recognized him as Jesus was Peter, because Peter said, Lord, if it's there, let me come to you. Now, you think about this for a moment. He's fixing to jump out of a good boat that's still up and floating right now. He's fixing to get out, amen, into the rough seas. And to walk on water was unheard of. Still is today. Can you walk on water? Neither can I. I can't even swim, so hey, you know, history. Walk on water. Let me walk to you. Jesus said, come. Do you trust me? Come. You trust me to come? The storms of your life? Then come to me. Come to me. I'm above your storm. Will you come? Will you come? Peter said, I'm coming. And he steps out of the boat, and the other one said, you're crazy, you're crazy. Don't trust him. That ain't the Lord. Don't trust him. Peter said, I know that voice, and he knows my voice. He said, come, I'm going. Well, go on in with your ignorant self. We're going to stay here. And they stayed in the boat, but Peter walked on the water toward the Lord. Walked on the water, mind you. Not swim, but he walked on the water just as the Lord did. Trusting God. Roots run deep. Well, I know many of you sitting there and you said, well, I heard the story before and Peter fell in the water. Well, whoop-de-doo. Huh? Tell me that you don't fall from time to time. You know why we fall in the water? Why do we let problems overtake us? Because we fail to keep our eyes on God and while we are trusting Him. Hello? If we're trusting Him totally, we'll always keep our eyes on Him. But thank God for mercy and grace. Amen? Thank God for mercy. What is mercy? Mercy is something you and I don't deserve. God, amen, showed us love when we didn't deserve love. He died for us when we weren't worthy to die for. Hello? Because He loved us. He showed mercy. He bought our salvation with His atoning blood. He made us a new creature in Christ according to His will and His love for us. Mercy. He showed mercy upon us. And He tells us here in Proverbs, let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Who is truth? Jesus. Who showed you mercy? He said, don't forget me. John 14:6, He said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to the Father except by me. You'll never get to heaven except through Jesus Christ. I don't care what anybody says. Amen? The Word of God clearly states, you, if you're going to get to heaven, you got to get it by Jesus Christ, and that is trust in Him. Don't ever forget what God has done for you, and don't forget who He is, the second point of this message. First is to listen to His commandments and do what He told you to do. Second, if you trust in Him, you won't forget who He is and what He's done for you. Hello? And folks, listen. Peter trusted Him. God showed him mercy, picked him back up. And the Bible said they was on the other side. When Jesus said you're going to the other side, you're going regardless of what you confront. Hello? He's going to see you through no matter what. All we got to do is keep trusting Him. Trusting Him and keeping our eyes on Him. On Him. The third thing I want you to see this morning, trust in Him and not yourself. We might seem like rocket scientists in here today, but we're not. I hate to pop your bubble. We think we're wise, but we're not. There is only one who is wiser in this world, and this is right here. Hello? Listen to what it says, and I'll do what it says. And everything will be all right. He said, trust not in unto your own self. Lean not unto your own self. Look at verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not unto thy own understanding. Because when we lean to our own understanding, our trust is gone and the problems overwhelm us. The Bible says here also to honor the Lord with all they have. You know, we say we trust God. We believe Him. He's going to take our souls to heaven. Now when it comes down to doing the service and doing what He's commanded us to do, we say, wait a minute, Lord. The first fruit of our increases that the Word of God teaches here is everything that God has blessed us with, whether it's our money, whether it's our time, talent, treasures, testimony, etc., on down the line. It's the whole package. Do we honor God with the first tenth of our increases? One-tenth of our increases. Do we give God the available time that He needs? Do we give Him us? He's going to give us 90% to do whatever we want to with it. But 10% belongs to Him as a child of God. If you're not a child of God, you don't have to listen to this because it don't apply to you. It applies to those who trust Him. Hello? It applies to... If we trust Him to take our souls to heaven, why can't we trust Him for what He's blessed us here with? Hello? If we can't trust Him with the material things down here, how in the world are we expecting Him to take our souls to heaven? Huh? It's just a thought here, hello? But it's a good thought. How can you trust Him to take you to heaven when you can't trust to give Him your time, your talent, your treasures, your testimony, and all down here? And your temple most of all. How many spend time in the Lord this week in His Word and prayer? But we spend more time on the TV. We say we want to be wise people, but do we? Just the thought. Come on, folks. We want to be godly people, but how much time do we spend to learn about godliness? We want a world that kids can grow up in and won't have to worry about getting shot when they go to schools. But how much time do we spend, amen, teaching the Word of God that thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not tell a lie, that should be honest, decent, and moral people? How much time do we take teaching that to our children? Uh-oh. No wonder we got the mess we got. No wonder we got to have DARE programs in the schools. No wonder we got to have an officer there all during the day. What happened to us? We forgot to give God the first increase. Hello? We forgot to give God our time, our talent, our treasure, our testimony. We forgot to teach it to our children. Or did we? Or are we just too busy with self? We say we trust God, but do we really trust Him? We put on our money in God we trust. But we trust more in George Washington and Benjamin than we do God. He says, look, if you're obedient and you've done all I've commanded you to do, He said, you're going to be happy. And your bonds, He said, there will be plenty in your bond. You'll never go lacking if you trust in God. But you got to learn to trust Him, don't you? And how can you learn to trust Him if you don't try? Matter of fact, in Malachi, He says, try me, test me. See if I'll not open the windows of heaven and pour blessings upon you can't receive. Hello? You know why America was blessed? Let me tell you why America was blessed. America was blessed because it honored God in the beginning. But it slipped a long ways from it today. Hello? And that's why you're not seeing the blessings upon the people. Hello? Because when you forget Him, there's no way He can bless you. He's only obligated to those who are obedient. Hello? No wonder we don't have any jobs. We forgot the One who blessed us with jobs. No wonder we don't have, amen, the smarts that we used to have. And a lot of people say, I beg a different on you. I beg a different you because we taught a bunch of generations now. They don't have to work. Just depend upon the government. Hello? Come on. Look. The government ain't got a quick fix. The government is you and I. Are you with me? And when you and I neglect the God who has blessed us, then friend, how in the world can we prosper? Because He said He'll prosper you who trust Him. Hello? He'll bless you who blesses Him and be obedient to what He says to do. So are we trusting God? Are we trusting God? Are we the tree that's planted by the water and our roots run deep? Are we trusting God? The last few things. Honor the Lord with what they have. And the last verse, it says, happy is the man that findeth what? Wisdom. And the man that getteth understanding. This is a very important chapter in the Word of God, as well as the rest. But today we're dwelling with this passage of Scripture. It's teaching us how to trust God. It's teaching us how to trust Him. Do we trust Him? Do we listen to what He's commanded us to do? What has He commanded us to do? First step is to come to know Him as the personal Lord and Savior of your life. Have you done that? That's the first step. Second now is to grow in that grace that He extended to you. Mature in the Lord. Every one of us, when we was born the first time, we had to grow up. Some of us growed up quick. Some of us growing up quick spiritually. But we got to grow up. We've got to become a man or a woman in Christ, if you will. We got to be believers 100%. Not 99.9%, but 100%. We can't go into church and say, I'm a Christian, then go outside and live like the devil. Hello? You can't use language the world uses on your Facebook pages and expect you to go to heaven. Hello? And represent Christ in that fashion. If you're going to live a Christian life and you're going to post, amen, you're a Christian, then friend, live the Christian life. Be one who represents Christ, not bring reproach upon Christ. Lift up the bloodstained banner high and not be ashamed. For He will give you holy boldness. You got to grow up and you got to trust Him, amen, to mature you in the things of the Lord. Be the light unto the world that is dark and evil. Show that you love the Lord in your action and your deeds. Be faithful to Him all the time. Amen? Be faithful to Him all the time, regardless whether it's Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, or Saturday. Be faithful to Him all the time. Don't forget what God has done for you and where He wants to take you to. Amen? Always remember what He's done. Trust Him and not yourself. Honor the Lord with what they have, and happy will you be. If you ain't happy, start trusting Him today. Let us do. Our Heavenly Father, God, as we come to You today, Lord, we thank You for Your love, Your grace. Thank You for the message. Father, use it for Your glory and Your honor at this hour. May Your Holy Spirit touch some heart here. And God, just move God in their lives. God, we need to trust You more. We say we are people that trust. But deep down inside, Lord, we really don't trust You when things come our way. Especially in these difficult times. We kind of limit You, God, and said that You're not above the storm.